Hey guys, my name's Kevin. I'm here with my friend Ryan. We're starting a new channel called Couch Co-op. It's really just gonna be us talking anything video game related. We both grew up playing video games in fairly different ways. And you'll kind of learn that about us as we go. Today's video is really just gonna be an introduction so you guys get to meet us. This is gonna be slightly awkward for us because we have known each other for a very long time. We've gone through a lot together, so we kind of know most of this, but we wanted to give you guys an opportunity to get to know us, meet us, and see if we're some personalities you wouldn't mind following in the future. But from that, I'm gonna throw it over to Ryan. He's gonna talk about kind of his background in gaming, what he likes to play, kind of what gaming meant to him growing up. So yeah.
Heck yeah, thanks, Kev. Gaming for me has always just been kind of a release, right? I'd get home from school, I'd get home from work, always throughout my life. It's just been my area where I get to take a step back. I get to dive into a world that wasn't, was currently bothering me. And that's been happening since I was about maybe 5 years old even. My first console I remember having was a Nintendo 64. And those things were just, they were the shit.
Yeah. They were the best.
They were the best. There's no better memory than putting in a cartridge, flipping the on button.
Blowing on it first.
I'd flip on the on button, and then when obviously the screen was black, I'd be like, ah, crap. Okay, take out the cartridge, blow on it nice and tight. I'd get it in, and I'd like make sure it's firmly placed, turn it on, still nothing, turn it off, take the cartridge back out. I used to sometimes even just lick it. I'd be like, oh, I just gotta get a little bit of grease, get a little bit of lube into it, help, you know, you gotta satisfy the N64 cartridge, right? You gotta bring it to completion.
We're gonna have to go over phrasing, aren't we?
We're gonna figure that out as we continue, but hey man, we'll be all right. the Nintendo 64 is definitely where I started some awesome games, the games that I love to play, Donkey Kong 64, Super Mario Brothers, Super Smash Bros.
Best theme song ever, Donkey Kong 64.
If you haven't heard the Donkey Kong rap, I definitely suggest you go Google that immediately. The DK rap's phenomenal. And then kind of Pokemon Stadium 1 and 2, the mini games were fire. Mm-hmm. They were the best. Other consoles that were important, Nintendo GameCube, Xbox 360 was huge. I played a ton of that. And then kind of from there was sort of PlayStation 4 and PC gaming. I'll throw it back to Kev, though, for, you know, his first consoles, what he grew up with.
So my background is a little different. Ryan, he didn't mention this, grew up in a family of five total?
Oh, yes. I'll list those off if you want.
No. He had four siblings. I have zero. So what that meant is, once I got done with homework, which for me meant I did it during class and my teachers hated me for it, I would come home and be bored out of my skull. I had no family members to do anything with. So my mom, being the good mom she is, bought me an N64 when I was like three.
Oh, heck yeah.
And she thought that was a good idea. However, when my dad bought me an N64 when I was also three, split family household, she hated it because he also bought me Mortal Kombat, and she thought that was not age appropriate for a three-year-old. Looking back on it, she may be right, maybe not. But video games for me were just something to do, but it was an incredibly fun thing to do. So like my memories growing up were playing like GoldenEye. I was really big into Super Smash Brothers when it first came out. Legend of Zelda, Majora's Mask.
Those were good ones.
Yeah. And growing up, just played a lot of that, you know, Game Boys, Pokemon, you know, like hundreds of hours across like multiple Pokemon games.
I played so much Red and Blue. I'm so there with you right now.
I think I restarted Yellow a million times until somebody told me I could take a Nidorino and beat Brock.
That was the worst gym battle, and I'm just gonna tangent here because the Yellow version Brock gym battle was the most atrocious gym battle ever. And yes, you get a Nidorino with double kick, you can catch a Mankey, you get a Butterfree with confusion. My five-year-old dumbass was like, nope, I'm gonna get a bunch of Pokemon that know tackle and hope for the best. And eventually it worked, but like, wow, did I hate myself.
My four-year-old brain spammed Thunderbolt even though it never worked.
My man,
anyway,
smart.
It was, yeah. So then growing up after that, played a lot of PlayStation 2, Nintendo GameCube. Again, a lot of Smash Brothers. Loved the Lord of the Rings video games on PlayStation 2. Played the crap out of those.
Wait, Lord of the Rings, Return of the King, hack and slash?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And yes. Like a ton of that. And my mom never let me play online gaming until I got like in eighth grade, I think I got a 360. And that was like my first introduction to like really multiplayer gaming. Because for me, multiplayer meant I had to have a friend come over, or I would go to my uncle's house and we would play like GoldenEye together. Like that was like the extent of my multiplayer background. So I grew up mainly playing single players.
That's very that's a good point.
Yeah, so like my favorite game growing up was on the original Xbox at my dad's house. I had Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. That was like my favorite game. I beat that like a ton of times. I had so much fun. You know, I can get into an entire tangent about it.
I mean, if we're...
But yeah, that's kind of what it's been. Now, I haven't bought a console since an Xbox One. I just mainly do PC gaming. Built my own computer after college. And yeah, I mean, we play, God, we play a ton of stuff at this point.
Yeah,
right?
We play like, a ton of stuff, but I mean, that kind of leads back to sort of, you know, how we started gaming, right? So like,
yeah.
Big games for me growing up, obviously Pokemon series. I've played every mainline Pokemon game, some to varying degrees. Some I have,
I think I stopped off in Black.
Yeah, most people, and that's pretty common, right? Gen 5 Pokemon, and that could be a topic in its own right, was pretty divisive, I think, in the Pokemon series. So that was huge for me, though. Always loved that game. You know, first shooter games would definitely be Halo 2, and then Halo 3 is kind of where, you know, I really got into first-person shooters. And then RPGs have always been big for me. I played a lot of World of Warcraft in high school. I was that kid. And like Fallout 3, I spent tons of hours of. Fallout 3 is a fantastic game. I don't know, Kevin, what you might have played.
My mom was so worried because my cousins were big into like Diablo 2 and WoW.
Yep.
She was so worried that I would get addicted to video games. Joke's on you.
Haha, here we are now, mom.
All right, dude, let's do this. What the hell?
Oh.
God damn it, Dad, get off our Xbox.
Yeah, that I could never play WoW or Diablo 2. My games growing up, a lot of Pokemon games. My friend and I, who I've known since I was 5, we would hang out with each other. We would play James Bond Nightfire on the GameCube. We sunk way too many hours into that. So like shooting games have always been a big part for me. So like I started with GoldenEye, played all the like the Bond games. My first introduction to like really heavy shooters was like Gears of War 2 specifically. I put way too many hours into that game.
Did you do competitive RPGs? Like multiplayer Gears of War or
yeah,
like a single player?
Yeah. No, we like game battles, Gears
Got
of War 2.
Okay.
Tons of that. And then RPGs were always big for me, so like I always played games like I said, Knights of the Republic. Mass Effect is like, I mean, both BioWare games, but Mass Effect is like one of my favorite games. Played a lot of like Super Mario RPG, Mario and Luigi Brothers in Time on the Nintendo DS.
Zelda,
yeah, just a lot
probably.
Of, yeah, a lot of Legend of Zelda. I've never really been big into MMOs and never really been big into RTSs. My only RTS experience was with like Warcraft 3 and Age of Empires, and I was so trash at those. And we also play a ton of board games.
Yeah.
Growing up, I played a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh. I played Magic semi-competitively from like high school through college. I was a judge at one point.
But like, you know, I'm pretty familiar with board games. I played a lot of Sorry, played a lot of Monopoly, played a lot of Life, Chutes and Ladders, you know how it goes. The classic.
We play a lot of deck building games, like DC deck building. I played like the Resident Evil deck building game. Ascension, played that a bunch
I've
too.
Played some Ascension in the past. Some other ones that I really like right now, Secret Hitler is really cool. Other ones, Betrayal.
Betrayal, obviously.
Classic.
Yeah, that's us.
Things we might want to talk about in the future, you know, like maybe specific video games, probably. Mm-hmm. video game topics. I mean, the reason this whole thing got started is we were talking about, you know, what do we think about the difficulty curve in video games and how necessary it is. So that's probably a topic we're going to touch on in the future.
Yeah, it just, at a point, it just became, we talk so much about video games, might as well just like throw them out on the internet and see what happens.
Right.
And see if what other people think, because we do like, we do want it to be constructive. We do want like feedback, and like the more people, the more voices in any conversation, the better it is, in my opinion. So that's kind of where this comes from. And yeah, I think it'll be a lot of fun, and I hope you guys kind of enjoy it and really engage with us as we kind of figure all this out too, because as you can tell, we have never done anything
This is super new for both of us. So if you stick around this far, thanks for watching, and hope you enjoy the content we put out in the future. So